This is the model I've been living by for the last 3 to 5 years. Pretty consistent with everything that I'm saying here. Like I always say in all my videos, you got to know your numeros. You got to know your numbers. You got to know it down to the penny. You have to. I'm pretty sure you know how tall you are. I'm pretty sure we all know how much we weigh, right? You could lie to yourself, but I'm pretty sure you know the real number. I'm pretty sure you know how old you is. So why don't you know your numbers, your financial numbers? You gotta know them, right? You can't just walk through life and willy-nilly, right? It's not gonna work. Gotta know your numbers. If you ask me my numbers any point of the day, I will give you straight answers. Next, always spend less than what I make. That's the principle. Can't go wrong. You cannot go wrong when you spend less than what you make. You really can't. It's a principle. Number three, I run as many bills and expenses through my personal and business credit cards for an average savings of about 10 to 15% per year. That looks like, in my business, that looks like anywhere from $10,000 to $15,000 in savings every single year in personal and business operations just by redirecting where I spend the money with what tool. Personal and business credit cards. Can't go wrong. My next principle is I save 40% of my gross annual income. I save 40% of my gross annual income. Okay, and then I'm going to share with you the breakdown. So example, last year I did $372,000 in revenue times that by 40%. That's $148,800. Okay, $148,000 minus $105,000 went into cash value life insurance amongst four different policies, two on myself, one on my fiance, one on my mom. Okay, so I'm funding four different policies. That total number is roughly $105,000 per year that goes into cash value life insurance. It's a little over six figures. From there, I max out my HSA. $3,850 is the current max. That number usually increases by like $50 every single year. So that's where the other $3,850 goes. That's what's left from 105 minus 148. And then the rest, which is a little over 10%, is dedicated to giving. I just give. So I'm saving 40% of my gross, which technically of the 40%, 10% went to like giving, right? So I saved the money so that I could give it. That's usually how I like to operate. Now, sharing with you the business operations, right? So if we did the math, 372 minus the 148.8, you should be left with 223,200 bucks. It costs me roughly $120,000 to run my business. That is a way overestimated cost. Sometimes I'm as low as 105K. It's usually no less than 100,000, no higher than 120,000 to run my business. So I'm then left with $103,200. That money then goes to the personal operation, run my personal life. So again, another super overestimated number is $72,000. Overestimated, so roughly 120 to run the business, 72 to run the personal. We're looking at just around 200K to live my personal and business life. Therefore, if I did 372, you minus business and personal operational expenses, right? You're finally left with 31,200. This number has no purpose yet, okay? So usually every year I do have some monies left over that just doesn't have a purpose, right? And that's fine. Like that's roughly a little under 10% of my income that doesn't really have a purpose. And then what ends up happening is I put that percentage, which is less than 10% of my income, I will put that money at risk. So put money at risk. What do I mean by that? So I may invest in something that is outside of my control, but I have a theory or a conviction that that will be a very good investment in the long term. Maybe it was crypto at one point. Maybe it was different types of stocks. Maybe it was me investing in a friend, in someone that is starting up a business. Maybe it was me lending money, right? Giving money out. Like I've given money. I've helped a friend buy out their car and now they're paying me back at an interest rate. I've lent money to family and friends. So that's technically putting money at risk because they could, what, screw me over, right? They could betray me. That's part of life. That will and may happen. So that remaining dollars is typically what I do with the money. And if none of that happens or I don't really see anything, then that money will roll over usually into the cash value life insurance. I may roll it over in there. or I will feed it back into the business operations. I might invest in another camera or invest in a better microphone. I might use this money to go to a mastermind like the And Asset Mastermind that I just went to. I'm going to Funnel Hackers Live this year, next month in Orlando. So that's what it means to me to put money at risk. All right, so it's not like I'm trying to lose the money. All right, so now my next money move, right? So I gave you the breakdown. This is how I operate. Super simple, nothing crazy. Know your numbers, spend less than what you make, save 40% of your income, right? I stick it in cash value life insurance. I stick it in HSA. I stick it in areas that I'm going to get tax-free income from. That's what I want, tax-free income. And then I feed the business. I always reinvest, right? I'm replenishing the business, right? Feeding it more so that I can pump more dollars out. Spend less than what I make on my personal operation going, right? Okay, here's my next money move that I learned about. So shout out to a YouTube channel called Self-Directed. Gentleman's name is Donnell. And seeing his stuff, pretty cool guy. We had a conversation. He was educating me on funding a self-directed 401k. And in order to have a self-directed 401k, you must have a business, right? So you have to have a business, and essentially your self-directed 401k is like a trust, right? So the money that I contribute to my own self-directed 401k, I'm going to get a tax deduction off my income, right? So I get the business, will receive the deduction. Then I convert the money to Roth status for tax-free growth for life and pay the taxes up front rather than later, right? So this is another vehicle where I can produce tax-free income outside of my cash value life insurance policies and outside of my HSA account. I'm not able to have a Roth IRA any longer because my income is too high, but I can still operate in a Roth environment. Like I can still have a Roth status by converting the self-directed 401k funds. This is what he was explaining to me. I don't know everything. I'm still learning. I may have made a mistake in what I just said. If I did, you can correct me in the comments, right? But this is what I'm looking at. This is my next money move. And then I'm gonna take it to the board here, take it back, take it to the whiteboard here real quick. So next money moves are right here. So first and foremost, the money that I said was not purposed or putting at risk, I'm gonna be applying that to real estate, right? My goal is to acquire at least anywhere from a 2 to 4 unit. I want to go the FHA route. I looked in Florida. The max on a 4 unit FHA loan is $1,072,600, I think. So I did make a mistake there. 3.5% down, $37K. I already have the down payment, have everything. It's just a matter of me finding the right deal. So that is the goal of the next 6 months. Hopefully by the new year, I can acquire my first real estate property. That is the goal, money move. Second money move is moving money, excess cash flow into a self-directed 401k to reduce taxes and then convert that money, then pay the taxes. So it's gonna be like I'm reducing taxes, but I'm paying taxes. So it's creating a bit of an offset. Pay the taxes up front because I know it's gonna be higher later on compounded money. And then that money will grow tax-free forever. And especially at my young age, 27, it doesn't make sense for me to put any dollar in any type of account that I'm going to be paying taxes later on. That does not make sense in my brain. I'm looking for tax-free income. That's what makes sense in my brain. Okay.